Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is George, and this is SaaS Master. Today, we're going to check out LoginPress, which is a pretty awesome login customizer. If you're tired of this nasty-looking WordPress login, well, we can change all that with LoginPress. We can do a pretty impressive login. Maybe you just hate the look, or maybe you have clients that you're building your WordPress site, and you don't want them to see this nasty login page with this nasty WordPress logo, and you can customize all that with LoginPress. Now, if you guys want to check out the deal, the link is going to be in the description. So this is their main site. You can see all the information right here, but what we're going to do is just head on over to the dashboard and see how we can customize our own login page. So once you install the main plugin, which is LoginPress PRO, if you have the pro version, you activate it and you get here this menu on the left side. This is the menu right here. And the first thing I would do is head on over to add-ons. So here on add-ons, you would add anything that you want to be added on. So if you want to add different type of situations like social login, if you want to give them that option, login widget, hide login, auto login, limit login attempts, login actions, and you just tick the button and it'll automatically download it and install it here on this site. Next thing you would want to do is head on over to settings and check out what you want to activate or deactivate. So for example, you can have forced login, force users to log in before viewing the site. And this could be used for multiple situations. Let's just say you have an exclusive site and you have like a private information. Well, if they want to actually view the whole site or any part of the site, they'd have to log in. So you'd force them to log in. You can have them enable reCAPTCHA, which is for security reasons. You don't want them to just do a brute force, try to log in. So you activate reCAPTCHA and it makes them have a harder time to try to hack your site. Session expires, so time in minutes, it can expire the session. Let's just say for security reasons, you don't want to give them more than 30 minutes in the site because they might go to lunch or they might, just leave the computer logged in and you don't want to risk anything, so you can limit the session. Auto remember me, custom password fields, login order, so both username and email, or just username or only email. So these are pretty cool options that you don't get normally with WordPress. Reset default settings, remove settings on uninstall. Just depends if you want to do that. Next thing you want to do, if you have these activated, you can do the auto login. You can select users to have a unique URL. They can log in to auto login URL. So let's just say I can't show that for security reasons. Well, yeah, I could. I'll just eliminate it. So let's just say the admin guy, if they go straight to this URL, they'd be auto login. That's pretty cool. Maybe you want to give a client the access for just, one-time access. You just create an auto login for them. They don't have to do anything like, hey, you don't have to give them password. You don't have to give them username. They don't have to have a hard time. Just head to this link and you log in. And you can activate it or deactivate it here on the add-ons. Next thing we have is the hide login. So basically, all WordPress links are like this right here, wp-admin. So if someone wants to hack your site, they just head on over to wp-admin and they would just brute force and try to hack you. And in the other hand, you change the login page. You can set whatever you want, just my login or admin, just any word you want, or just do like a generate slug randomly, see that? And that would be your login page instead of having the default login page where hackers know that they can hack you there. You can send the email after changing wp-login.php. That means if you forget what your login page is, you can head on over to the email and check it out. Next thing we have is this pretty cool option, which is social login. Maybe you have a site that's a little bit more complex that you created, a classified ad site or whatever like that. You can give them the option to Facebook login, Twitter, Google, or LinkedIn. Now, to activate these, you gotta enter the Facebook app ID or the app secret. You can have the help files right here and show you how to do this. It's not hard at all. You just gotta head on over and follow the instructions. And we got the enable social login, so you can enable it on the form, register form, and remove record on uninstall. So those are the main settings. Now let's head on over to the juicy part, where is the WordPress customizer. You can click here on this link or you can click over here. So once you head on over to the customizer, it's going to take us to WordPress customizers for the login. You can see how this is much different than this. But that's not all. This is just like the basic one. First thing I would do is just head on over to templates and check all these templates out and try to find which one is best for me. I mean, what works best? Are you looking for the professional look? Are you looking for the playful look? It just depends what you want. But this looks much more professional than having the ordinary WordPress login. See how all these can be selected? Let's wait for it to load up. Actually, I want to select this one. Check how nice this one looks. So what we can do is we can customize the background. If we click right here, so for example, change background, we can select another background if we want. See how nice that looks? Or we could just keep that blurred one on the back. If you want to keep it a little bit more professional, more nice, you can see that right there. We can also change the logo. If we click on the logo, we can remove it. So let's just say I want to choose this one over here. Select it, super easy. And let's say that's a little bit too small. So we just change the size. That looks okay. Logo height. Okay, so just change that there. Just want to show you how customizable this is. You can put a URL right here. So for example, let's just say I'm a company who's doing websites for them. And I want to use this login with my company logo. And if they click on it, they'll head on over to my site. That could be an example, or just put the company's own logo right here. Logo title, if they hover over it, it's going to put their own title. Let's go back, see what other customizations we can do. Google fonts, we can change that right here. See how that changed? Roboto, if you don't like the original font. So just checking this out. Okay, let's just keep the Roboto one. Okay, so just Google fonts. We can change the background, you saw that already. Customize login form. So form background, form width, all this right here. Padding, you can change all that. Let's head on back. Customize form get, see that there. Recaptcha, if you wanna add it here also. Captcha, button beauty, see this right there. If you click on this, customize button, you see that right there, customize colors. So if we want to go back, let's just say that's the one right there, and I click on the customize button, it'll take me back there also. Let's just say my site's color is purple, right? You can change that to purple, pink, any color you want. Button border color, see that? So there's no border right now. Let's see where the border is. Shadow, we can add some shadow. See, that gives it a little different touch. Opacity, just a little bit. Text size, maybe that's too small. You want to go a little bit bigger. Depends how you want it. And head back over here. We got the error message. So these are the error message if they put an invalid password. So invalid username, you can change this. You can customize that also. Depends what you want to change the text message. Welcome message also. So welcome message on lost password, login page, all this can be changed. See that right there? There we go, reset password hint. Form footer. So right now I don't see any footer right here. So maybe we can change that. Oh, it's over here, the form footer. You can see this right here. If I click away. So maybe because it's in Spanish, it changes it. So it tells you go back. You can switch on and off, background text, font size. So maybe put a little bit bigger if they forgot the password. Now just heads up, that's in Spanish, so don't worry about that. Back color, so we can change that right here. We can also do a little bit of customizing right here if you don't want it white, different colors. So I'm just showing you all the customizations you can have this right here. I mean, if you dedicate a bunch of time to this, I'm pretty sure you can change everything. You just need to take some time. And it just depends if you want to use a template or not to change that. Also, if you want to view this, how it will look on a tablet or on a phone, shows you that also. Keep this a computer. Now, if you like the way this looks, you just publish it and it's ready. Now, let's log out and show you that this is done. So let's close session. And now this is the login page. Check that out. Check how nice this looks compared to this. I mean, it's completely different, more nicer, way better looking. So guys, this is LoginPress. Like I said, if you guys want to grab the deal that's available, the link is going to be in the description. Well, my name is George, and this is SaaS Master. See you guys later.